A lot of people have asked me how to do that mirror trick in Filmora. You know, the one where it looks like the reflection is actually talking in a different way than you are, almost like it's a different person? I actually don't know how to do that effect.
Do you?
Yeah, I totally do. I can show you how.
Cool. You're in good hands. I gotta take a shower.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
The real trick to this effect is learning how to set up your shot. And what I mean by that is, if you look at the picture up in my preview window here, I've created a layout for this particular effect where I had myself on the left and I had the mirror set off to the right. In my bathroom, there's actually a little medicine cabinet nook here that has a very intentional vertical line that I wanted to take advantage of. So setting the shot up this way was really important to what I'm going to do next. So what I did is I started to read my line, and I made sure I turned to the mirror and interacted so it absolutely seemed like the reflection in the mirror was me standing in front of a mirror talking. But if you look, I really tried to make sure that I never crossed that center line. I kept myself on one side, and I kept the mirror image on the other. Now, when I got to the point where I wanted to talk to the mirror and have it talk back to me in a different way, I actually turned and I asked the question, and I stayed very still here for a minute, as still as I could, and I waited, and then I spoke the response line back in the mirror. And then I waited, trying to hold that same pose and get back to where I was. Then I spun back and gave my response. So this was one continuous shot that I started from the beginning right to the end. Now, the reason I left these big spaces in here is very intentional. I found a spot right before the response started, right where my facial expression started to change. Can you see that happening? I'm pretty still, and then my eyebrows start to raise. I got right to that point and I split that footage. And then I went to the point where I spun my head. So take a look at me on the left and watch for right when my head starts to turn, right about there. And I split the footage one more time. I don't know if you realize this, but if you grab your footage, left click and hold, you can actually lift up and bring it up into another track will be created. Now what I want to do is get to the point where I spoke and I turned to the footage and my hair just stopped moving. And that's where I want to introduce this second piece of footage. They're a little bit off, but they're pretty close. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce a mask onto the upper section of footage, and I'm going to separate these two. Because right now, with this being on the upper track, all you see is that upper piece of footage, and it blocks out everything in the track below. So from here, let's go up into the effects tab, and let's go down to the utility section on the lower left. Now see here where it says image mask? I want you to left click on that, drag it down and put it right on top of your upper track. That is now applied a mask to this track. And you may not be able to see it because these two pieces are very similar. You can almost see the circle here. Let me turn off the other track. Let me click the eyeball. Now you can see the upper track has been masked so that only that circle is allowed to show. But we don't want a circle, we actually want to separate it down the middle. So the way we're going to do that is double left click on that upper track. Let's go over to the video section in the upper left, click on that tab. And down at the bottom, you'll notice that video effects now has a check mark on it. And that's because we added that mask. Now, as I scroll through these preset masks, you'll see the circle is the one that's selected. But I actually want to use this other mask over here. Double left click on that and it applies it. So it's set off to the right. Everything to the right, this checkerboard pattern is what will show through. Everything black is what will be masked off. Now what we can do with this X section here is control where these lines are. If we move this over to the right, we can line that up pretty much right with my little cabinet line over here. And I'm only using the right side of this footage in the upper track. Let's turn the lower track back on. Now can you see what's happening? We're looking at the left side of the bottom track footage and the right side of the upper track footage. So when I get to this point, it looks like the reflection in the mirror does something on its own. But the next thing I want to have happen is the bottom track. I want to be able to turn back to the camera. So once this upper track is done seeing its response, right about here, I'm going to take the lower track and I'm going to slice that footage and get rid of this end piece right here. Now let's go back and grab our other footage that we snipped right about where my head turned and slide that over. Now what'll happen is it looks like the reflection in the mirror stops talking and then I spin my head. Now, it's not completely smooth. Can you see the changes in here? They're a little off. I can spot the change. If you just look on the left, I can spot that change where that splice is. So now I want to see if I can try to smooth these out a bit. Let me start with this lower one. I'm going to expand this footage so that we can see it. I'm going to start a little later in this head turn. Let's start right about there. And I'm going to slice this footage one more time down below. I'll eliminate this middle section. And I'll slide that back over. Another way you can do in that is just click on the space and hit delete on your keyboard. It'll move you over. Or turn your ripple delete on, which is the link chain up on the left. Let me see if that's a little bit smoother. It's just a little bit off, but I think I can take care of that with a fast dissolve. I'm going to go up into my transitions tab, and I'm going to search for the dissolve transition. If I start to type DIS, it shows up. Let's bring that down into this section between those two pieces of footage, click on the end and bring it in and make a very quick dissolve right here. Can you see here? I'm going to just shrink this way down. Just a very quick dissolve that goes from this footage to the other. You can just barely see it, but I want to help splice these footages together so they make a little more sense. Let me play that in real time and see if it's a little smoother. See, at real speed, you don't notice that splice quite as much if we dissolve between it. Now, also up here, where this goes from me sitting still, let me find right where my eyes go up, right about there. I'm going to splice this one more time and just lose that beginning section. And I just want to go to the point where my eyes open up. And I'm going to put a very slight dissolve at the beginning of this as well. So I'll left-click on that dissolve, drag it down to my top footage. Let me shrink it so I can see the whole dissolve. And let me pull that way, way back. I just want a really quick dissolve where it just immediately dissolves and my eyes open up. See, it's very quick. It's going from the original footage to the new one, but it's so fast and it starts at the motion that helps it sell that effect. Now let's shrink it down and take a peek and see if it's noticeable. I can smooth that out a little bit, and I can also find a little better spot to transition, but just play with that until you get it where you really like it. For me, a lot of the trick is being able to stay very still. The least amount of movement you do in between these shots, the smoother it'll feel. If you want to learn more Filmora tips and tricks, make sure you check out this next video coming up right here. Peace.